Let us discuss a very important topic in solid state physics, that is the Miller indices. We know crystalline solid are anisotropic. That is why the orientation of the plane is important in the crystal structure analysis. For orientation of any crystal plane, we need minimum 3 points in the plane, provided the 3 points are not collinear. You see, inside the crystal, the different planes are not collinear. They are not parallel to each other here. So when we do the crystal structure analysis by giving X-ray diffraction, using X-ray diffraction, then you will not get the diffracted beam of X-rays in the detector. So what we generally do, we make proper rotation of these materials so that the incident X-ray fall on the diffracting planes of the atoms like this, okay, so that the reflected X-rays passes through the detector and diffraction pattern is observed through this detector. And in the crystal structure analysis, the diffracting planes of the large number of crystals should satisfy Bragg's law. The set of parallel planes have same interplanar spacing. You see, these are the set of parallel planes, and they have, and the space between, the distance between the parallel planes, it's called the interplanar spacing. The orientation of a diffracting plane or the family of diffracting planes is specified by a set of three numbers called Miller indices. So how to find out the Miller indices of the diffracting plane in a crystal? The first thing you have to do, take any atom in the crystal as origin and you draw coordinate axis in the direction of the basis vector. You see in the figure, suppose this is the origin of the crystal system, and here you see A1, A2 and A3. These are three basis vectors. A1, let us say, along the direction of X, and A2 basis vector along the direction of Y, and A3 is along the direction of Z. Basis vectors are nothing but the direction of the lattice constant. You may say the lattice constant. This is one lattice direction of one lattice constant. This is another lattice constant, and this is the third lattice constant. You see, along the basis vector A1, you have intercept is 3, and along the basis vector A2, you have intercept 2, and along the basis vector A3, you have intercept 2. Now, write the intercepts of the lattice constant or the basis vector. Here, the intercept of the plane are 3, 2, 2. Okay. Then now the third point, in the third step, take the reciprocal of these intercepts. So the reciprocal will be equal to 1 by 3, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. Now find the LCM and multiply each by the LCM. So if you multiply the LCM of 3, 2, 2 will be equal to 6. So if you multiply here 6, here 6 and here 6, then you will get the smallest three integers having the same ratio will be equal to 2, 3, 3. So the Miller indices of the plane are 2, 3, 3. And the Miller indices is generally denoted with the parenthesis, semi bracket. It will be denoted by the semi bracket. So the result enclosed in parenthesis HKL, you say these three numbers as HKL, is called the index of the plane or Miller index of the plane. So from Miller indices, it is clear that for this plane, you have another parallel planes which parallel to this at some distance apart. The other planes are at some distance apart. In the vertical direction, so to say, and parallel to this plane, and whose index is 233. Now let us discuss about the Miller indices of planes in cubic crystal. You need cubic crystal because cubic crystal is very simple. So first, we basically deal with Miller indices in cubic crystals. And we know in cubic crystal, the plane having intercept 1 infinity infinity is parallel to YZ plane. You see, for this cubic crystal, the plane have intercept along x-axis, the intercept is y is 1, and along y-axis the intercept is at infinity, and in z-axis the intercept is at infinity because this plane is parallel to y-axis. So they will meet at infinity. So the intercept for y-axis, the intercept is infinity. For z-axis, the intercept is infinity. And for x-axis, the intercept is 1. From origin to this is equal to 1. For an intercept at infinity, the corresponding Miller index will be equal to 0 because 1 by infinity is equal to 0. So for y-axis, the Miller index will be equal to 0. For z-axis, the Miller index will be equal to 0. Therefore, Miller index of plane having intercept 1, infinity and infinity will be equal to 1, 0, 0. You see, for the cubic crystal, having the plane, this for this plane, the intercept will be equal to infinity, 1, infinity. For x-axis, this plane is parallel to x-axis. So the intercept for x-axis will be infinity, and the intercept for z-axis will be equal to infinity, and the intercept for the y-axis will be equal to 1. So for the Miller index for this plane, you see, for this plane having intercept infinity, 1 and infinity will be equal to 0, 1, 0. And for this plane, you consider this plane where the intercept is infinity, infinity, and 1. You see, for this plane, the Miller index will be equal to 0, 0, 1. Now, let us discuss if the plane cuts the axis on the negative side of the origin. Okay, if the plane cuts the axis on the negative side of the origin, what will be the Miller index? The corresponding Miller index will be negative. Okay, if a plane cuts the axis on the negative side of the origin, the corresponding Miller index is negative, and it is indicated by placing a minus sign above the index. If k is negative, then you have to put a bar. You have to put a bar. This is the minus sign over K. So it will be H K bar L. Consider a cubic crystal as shown in the figure. This is your x-axis, this is your y-axis, and this is your z-axis. And this plane, which is shown by a shaded person, this is the plane having intercept. Having intercept infinity, y is also infinity, and z is equal to minus 1. You see, it is in the opposite direction of z axis. So z is minus 1, and the Miller index of this plane will be equal to 0, 0, minus 1, or 0, 0, 1 bar. So in cubic crystal, the plane having intercept infinity, infinity, minus 1 is 0, 0, 1 bar. Now, the third point, the set of parallel planes have Miller indices. Sorry, द इंडिसेस एचकेएल में डिनोट ए सिंगल प्लेन और ए सेट ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेन्स। रिमेम्बर द मिलर इंडिसेस एचकेएल इट में डिनोट ए सिंगल प्लेन और इट में डिनोट ए सेट ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेन्स। यू सी इन दिस फिगर ए सेट ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेन। सपोज दिस इज योर एक्स एक्सिस, दिस इज योर वाई एक्सिस एंड दिस इज योर जेड एक्सिस। ओके एंड द प्लेन्स शोन इन द फिगर हैव इंटरसेप्ट। फॉर दिस प्लेन द इंटरसेप्ट इज वन इन्फिनिटी इन्फिनिटी एंड फॉर दिस प्लेन द इंटरसेप्ट इज टू इन्फिनिटी इन्फिनिटी एंड फॉर दिस प्लेन द इंटरसेप्ट इज थ्री इन्फिनिटी इन्फिनिटी एंड द सेट ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेन्स हैव मिलर इंडिसेस 100। फॉर दिस द मिलर इंडिसेस इज 100, फॉर दिस ऑल्सो 100 एंड फॉर दिस ऑल्सो 100। नेक्स्ट पॉइंट द सेमी ब्रैकेट एच के एल रिप्रेजेंट्स ए प्लेन एंड द कर्ली ब्रैकेट एच के एल रिप्रेजेंट्स ए फैमिली ऑफ प्लेन्स। रिमेंबर इट रिप्रेजेंट्स ए फैमिली ऑफ प्लेन्स। एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द क्यूब फेसेस ऑफ ए क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल आर डिफरेंट मिलर इंडिसेस 100, 010, 001, 1/00, 01/00, 001/00। The planes equivalent by symmetry. These planes are equivalent by symmetry, and they may be denoted by curly bracket or braces around the indices. So the set of cube faces have Miller indices of family of planes of a cubic crystal written as 100 with curly bracket. Fifth point, the square bracket HKL represents the direction. Remember. Square bracket HKL represents the direction. In cubic crystal, the direction HKL is perpendicular to the plane HKL. Okay. In cubic crystal, the direction HKL is perpendicular to the plane HKL. Plane is HKL represented by semi bracket. Having the same indices, the direction indices of the direction HKL is same as the direction of the indices of the plane. The indices Miller index of the plane is same as the Miller index of the direction. And in general, it is not true for other crystal systems. And if you write HKL by this notation, it represents family of directions. So you may say HKL average. This represents family of directions. So there is a question with a schematic diagram. So planes having Miller indices 110 and 111 in cubic crystal. So consider the cubic crystal like this, as shown in this figure. Suppose this is your x-axis, this is your y-axis, and this is your z-axis. And the Miller index 110, this plane, for this plane, you see the Miller index is 110. Again, consider the cubic crystal. This one, suppose this is your x-axis, this is your y-axis, this is z-axis. And for this plane, as shown in the figure, the Miller index will be 111. You see, for this in this figure, here the x intercept is 1, y intercept is 1, and z intercept is also equal to 1. So for this plane, the Miller index will be equal to 111. Now let us discuss the relation between interplanar spacing and plane indices or Miller indices HKL. What is the relation between interplanar spacing and Miller indices HKL? Consider a set of parallel planes having Miller index or indices HKL. Here let us we discuss first the two parallel planes. Suppose the interplanar spacing, the length between the parallel plane is equal to d, or the interplanar spacing is equal to d. Suppose in this figure you have two planes. One is the plane here, another one is the plane here. You may say this is a dotted plane and this is a solid plane. This plane is the solid plane, and the dotted plane, this plane is parallel to this solid plane here. The solid plane is basically, let us say, due to A, B and C. And the center of dotted plane, let us say N, and the center of solid plane is equal to O. And suppose ON, it is the lattice spacing. It is the spacing between, or the, you may say, the interplanar spacing D. From O to N, the interplanar spacing is D. And the interplanar spacing D makes an angle alpha, beta and gamma. Okay. It makes an angle alpha with the x-axis. It makes an angle beta with the y-axis. And it makes an angle gamma. This angle is gamma with the z-axis. And you see, if A, B, C are the lattice parameters, okay, along the x, y and z, suppose A, B, C are the lattice parameters, small a, small b and small c, along the direction x, y, z, then the intercept of lattice parameters along x, y and z will be equal to A by h. This will be A by h. And for this it will be B by K, and for this it will be equal to C by L. So for this intercept it will be A by H 0, 0. For this intercept you will be 0 B by K 0, and for this intercept it will be 0, 0 C by L. So from geometry, your cos alpha value, you see, cos alpha value will be equal to D divided by A by H, this length. Okay, similarly, your cos beta value will be equal to D divided by B by K, and cos gamma value, this value gamma, so cos gamma value will be equal to D divided by C by L. So, you got the value of cos alpha and D divided by A by H, so cos alpha will be equal to D into H by A. Similarly, cos beta will be equal to D into K by B, and cos gamma will be equal to D divided by L by C. And from three dimensional geometry, we know cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma will be equal to 1. So if you substitute the value of cos square alpha, cos square beta, cos square gamma, it will be equal to D square into H square by A square plus K square by B square plus L square by C square, that will be equal to 1. So D square will be equal to 1 divided by this amount, and D will be equal to 1 divided by H square by A square plus K square by B square plus L square by C square square root, or to the power half. And if you take a cubic system, then A will be equal to B will be equal to C. So if you substitute A, B, C equal to A, then it will be equal to, D will be equal to A divided by H square plus K square plus L square square root. That is, from this expression you see, greater the Miller indices, the shorter the interplanar spacing. If the interplanar spacing will be shorter, then the Miller indices will be greater. That means if D will be shorter, then HKL, the Miller indices will be shorter. That is, if the interplanar spacing in the crystal will be more, then you will find short value, small value of Miller indices. So, this is a brief discussion about the index system for crystal planes. Thank you.